Now I had a session on this machine. What's the name of the machine, Ron?
Digital Boxing Trainers Assistant, DBTA.
Trains your speed. He don't lie. He measures your speed by every punch you make. Left hook, right hook, left straight, uppercuts. This thing don't lie. I'm super sharp right now, I think. If my trainer tells me that I'm super sharp, then I know it for sure, because normally he always makes jokes that I'm slow. So now he say I'm super fast and it goes better every time I go around on this DBTA. Feels very good, man. When I was his age, I was not so good as him. So he's much better at his age than I was at my age when I was 12. He lives in a boxer family, you know, in a fight family. He has to be unlucky if he don't get the big champion. I think he has a very bright future ahead of him. If he just listened to his father and his grandfather and just do the things what I say, what he can do it best for his career, and I think it will be a great champion in the future.
But he says he was not so good at my age as I am now, but I have better trainers than he had when he was the same age like me.
Yeah, of course that's true. I have to do it all by myself. I go to a gym when I was his age, and I have to get the attention from the trainer at that moment. But he is—he was born and he was already walking around with little gloves. I like to see him do what he likes to do. If he wants to play football, then I like it too. He wants to be like me, and he trains very hard and he listens good. And if he just stay polite and stay himself, then everything will be fine. Gonna eat something right now and then meet up with my wife and my kid. Look a little bit like to the horse driving, and then I go home and have one day relax, and then Monday again I'll train. Yes, she's proud of her horse and she wants to watch me see her drive fast and jump and everything. She's really talented. She really likes it. She's like 3-4 times in the week she's here. So it's close to my home. Yeah, she's really loving horse riding. Same like my wife, she also loves it. I just support. If she wants to do horse driving, I support her also. But I'm not a guy who likes to ride horse, because I almost have one time an accident with my wife. The horse just tried to kill me, I think. I was on it and he get raged and he's running and I can't stop. So I jumped off and I never horse drive again. Makes me smile, makes me happy. Makes me happy that she can do what she likes to do. And have a really good youth, you know. When she's older, she thinks about it and she knows she has a happy environment to live in.
No elbow, no pinching. Okay, good fight. Chicken.
It's a Kickboxing One Super Series clash of the highest order. Nieky Holzken finally in the One Super Series cage, and Cosmo Alessandre there for the second time. Is Alessandre on tonight? Can he get out of the way of the hands of Holzken? And can Holzken get out of the way of the knees of Alessandre? Michael Chevello, Mitch Chilson with you. Let's see if Holzken gets his hands off early here. It's an outside thigh kick from the Dutchman. There's the Brazilian going downstairs. Huge trapezius and shoulders on Cosmo Alessandre. Fires out a front kick. Little switch there from Alessandre. Chin tucked, looking through the brow. Now under our kickboxing rule set, you can clinch for as long as 3 seconds and throw the knees. But you've got to keep the knees continual. Inside leg kick to that femoral profunda there from Holzken. And Alessandre just upends him. Go. You can sense the intensity in this one. Both men capable of finishing the other. There's a hook to a right hand from Holzken. And a head kick! A head kick from Nieky Holzken! He drops Cosmo Alessandre.
Wow, no setup to that left high kick. Beautifully done in time.
No count, though, I think, there from referee Onari. Holzken, though, will be brimming with confidence. Probing with a jab to set the right cross, perhaps. And there it goes. Alessandre looping his punches.
So that not count as a knockdown.
Oh, that will. That has to. And there's the count from referee Onari. So if the first one wasn't a knockdown, this second one was. Three knockdowns in a round and it's over. And Holzken is on the money so far.
Holzken seems to be targeting the right side of Alessandre's head.
Alessandre getting airborne. Rare for him. Here come the hands of Holzken again. That 14-1 pro boxing record shining through now. Alessandre says, is that all you've got? Got to get off the cage here, Alessandre. Holzken will have his way with him with the hand. Jumping knee! And referee Onari breaks them. What a start to his one Super Series career for Nieky, the natural Holzken. Inside leg kick from the Dutchman. Uppercut there from Cosmo. Holzken measuring the right hand here. Sets it up with the left very nicely, usually. Outside leg kick. Counter look there for Cosmo. Turning back kick to the liver from Holzken.
Cosmo's kick. Guy has to get off that cage. Nieky's backing him up.
Jumping knee. And a liver shot from Holzken. And a spinning back fist. How do you do? Welcome to One Super Series, Nieky Holzken.
Look at this beautiful no-chamber head kick. Catches Cosmo right on the side of the head. And then he comes up with a huge left hook that hits him in the exact same spot. And that one counted as a knockdown. And if there is a knockdown, we do score it 10-8 in that round. Good work from Nieky Holzken in his debut. He's landing a lot of power shots. We're not seeing the pretty and the finesse, but we are seeing the power added to Holzken.
I told you earlier, the hands of Holzken may be the difference here. And certainly that was the case in the opening round. Let's see if Alessandre can get close to work the knees to the liver. Stares at Holzken across the cage in front of this magnificent audience inside Stadium Astora in Jakarta, Indonesia. Second round. Front kick early on from Alessandre. Roundhouse kick from Alessandre. Just tries to tuck it under the right elbow. Three in a row there from the Brazilian. This is more like it from Cosmo. Again, cannot allow himself to be backed up against the cage. Now gives himself that space he needs.
I'm not used to seeing Cosmo on his back foot. He's usually the one that's aggressive. He's the one that's usually pushing forward.
A rematch 8 years in the making. Last time it was Holzken in 2010 who won a unanimous decision. Holzken trying to walk him down here, trying to get Cosmo against the cage. Roundhouse kicks off the lead leg from Cosmo. Are the recipe here in the second thus far. Jab from Alessandre, nicely done. Circling dangerously into the power side of Holzken. Now he drifts off to Holtzman's left, but back in the power side again. Holtzman jabbing, fakes the right hand. Cosmo switching angles. There's that left roundhouse kick to the right rib cage once more. Keeps going forward here, Cosmo. Have they found a chink in the armor of Nieky Holzken? Step up knee, nicely done there from Alessandre. He's got the right idea. Much better round for the Brazilian. Beautiful left hook and then a body shot from Holzken. Hamilton into the carcass. Drifts back to center cage, does Alessandre.
Cosmo's doing a good job of throwing shots off his back foot.
That was a beautiful double side combination. Right roundhouse kick to a right hand there from Alessandre, something you rarely see. Thrust out the jab. Outside leg kick from Holzken, then goes to the inside lead thigh. Much better second round from Alessandre here. Needed a confidence boosting round after getting dropped in the first. Two punch combination, short knee on the inside, nothing really connecting clean there for Alessandre. Right hand lead down the tube from Holzken. Jab from Alessandre. No mustard behind that right hand from Holzken. There's a solid right hand to the temple. There's a high kick from Holzken. And Cosmo says, you've got to do better than that.
Michael, we do have confirmation from referee Onari during the break that that round, the first round, it did score two knockdowns for Nieky Holzken.
Okay, good clarification there. Two knockdowns on Cosmo shows you just how close it came to ending for the Brazilian in the first round. One knockdown from a high kick, one knockdown from a punch. Oh, spinning hook kick, how do you do? Nieky Holzken trying to go kleptomaniac and steal the round. He's
catching
the big come off! The big come off! And stood that freaking Irene! Nieky Holzken knocks out Cosmo Alessandre!
Wow, right at the bell, he throws an uppercut. Michael Chiavello said the hands would be the undoing of Cosmo Alessandre, and he hit it right on the button. Look at that uppercut. Just sleeps Cosmo Alessandre. Welcome to One Super Series, Nieky Holzken.
That was like detonating a skyscraper. That final punch that crumbled Cosmo Alessandre. He was like a marionette that had the strings cut from under him. Amazing scenes here. Nieky Holzken, One Super Series debut, knocks out Cosmo Alessandre in the final seconds of the round. Let's go to Dom Lau, make it all official, my word.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 59 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of knockout, Nieky Holzken!
Nieky Holzken has arrived in One Super Series. Nieky Holzken demolishes Cosmo Alessandre, but there's the respect, the honor, the integrity, the martial arts Bushido spirit. And the winner's medal goes back to the Netherlands. Nieky Holzken, a punishing performance. Sheer dominance from the Dutchman.
This is one kickboxing rule, okay? Three means three rounds. No elbow. No,
Roblo. It's only 3 seconds, okay? Final instructions from referee Atsushi Onari. A massive crowd inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena as One Super Series finally launches. It's 3 by 3 minute rounds. There's nowhere to run. There's nowhere to hide. It's all out striking action. It's Regian Eersel in the black, Brad Riddell in the white. Good outside thigh kick for Riddell. Jab two to a hook there from Riddell. Eersel looks for the inside thigh. You can see the reach differential, the height differential between the two. This is under kickboxing rules. No knees, no elbows, no grappling permitted.
You can see the stance difference, Michael. You can see how Regian Eersel's got that nice high guard. There's this very like Dutch Muay Thai, Dutch kickboxing, while Riddell's got those hands a little bit lower, likes to work inside. There's that hook you were talking about earlier.
The speed and the power combined on the hands of the Kiwi, Brad Riddell. But look out for the high looping roundhouse kicks of Regian Eersel. And Eersel smiles at Riddell. So far, a very defensive start from the Dutchman. And there's the first head kick, going for the headache maker. And Riddell looks for the liver again.
Riddell's a little bit quicker to get out of the gate. He's really pushing forward. Eersel's trying to slow it down. It's, you know, more of a Muay Thai style, how they like to relax in that first round.
Beautiful inside leg kick there from Regian Eersel. Jab from Riddell. Takes the inside thigh kick, Riddell. There's a front kick to the midsection from Eersel. Riddell got to be careful when he throws the left on the inside, not to leave his head exposed for a counter strike. Eersel did say he would decision Riddell tonight, has tremendous respect for Riddell. Riddell said, I'll knock him out, I'll catch him with a counter shot, I'll KO the Dutchman.
I like how Riddell's using the angles. He's throwing a combination and he's sliding out left or right, and he's out of the way of any counters.
Speed a factor so far for Brad Riddell. Beautiful pirouette off to his left, quarter angle turns from the Kiwi. Goes down the center corridor with the right hand. Regian Eersel in a very strange range at the moment. He's not within kicking range, and he's not within boxing range with that reach of his. The range is all Brad Riddell right now.
It's that footwork of Riddell. He's in and out. He attacks the body, and he moves left and right very, very fast. And Ursel's finding a hard time getting his rhythm.
You see the distance that Riddell had there. Eersel cannot get the full extension on his punches, and that's what he relies on, the full extension on the kicks and on the punches. Riddell, double jab, backs off. There's the left hand. Great first round here from Brad Riddell. Our three judges ringside are scoring each round on a 10-point must system. So the winner of the round will get a 10-9 round. If there's a knockdown, the person knocking the other down will get a 10-8 round. Left roundhouse kick there from Eersel. Beautiful parry of the kick from Brad Riddell. So just to give you a sense, I'm sure at home you would have scored that round to Brad Riddell. That makes it a 10-9 round to Brad Riddell.
He moves in, but as Brad Riddell is coming forward, he does drop his hand, so he is open to a possible counter. Let's see if Eersel picks up on that. But he's moving so well. He's coming in, he throws his combination, and he's gone. He's out of the way with that slick footwork.
Couple of things here. The reason they call Regian Eersel the Immortal is because he comes out of his corner always much quicker than his opponent. They say, well, he's immortal, he can't be beaten, he doesn't get energy sapped from him. So look out for that. Another thing, having commentated Regian Eersel for a number of years, this is an uncharacteristically slow start for the Dutchman.
Okay. Didn't take the seat there. He didn't take the stool. He took the whole minute standing, so maybe he's warmed up and ready to go, but he's having a difficult time with that range. He hasn't found his spot yet.
Have a look how Riddell will try and get into that beautiful range again and just sit there. It's a range that negates the hands, negates the legs at full extension of Regian Eersel. Left hook from Riddell. Beautiful jab, threaded it through. Nice little feint. High kick from Eersel. Got to be careful not to throw that as a knee. No knees permitted under kickboxing rules. There's a right hand from Riddell.
That knee is a game changer. It comes all the way up to Riddell's chin. If he connects on one of those, the tide is definitely going to shift in his favor.
Body shot from Eersel. Speed again coming to the fore here for New Zealand's Brad Riddell. Eersel, I think he's only maybe thrown one, perhaps two high roundhouse kicks that have come close to Brad Riddell. Very unlike Regian Eersel. And there's a good looping left hand from the Dutchman. Step through knee. Now these knees aren't permitted under kickboxing rules. Jab to body shot from Brad Riddell. Jab two again. There's the hook in the right hand. And now Eersel finds some power salvos.
and he immediately circles out, so he's not there for that counter knee. See, he steps off beautifully off to the left there to avoid that knee. He's coming in with the punches, and he immediately turns out to the side.
Good counter right hand there from Regian. Eersel then goes to the body. Riddell with the jab too. Front kick from Eersel.
Like to see Eersel throw out that jab, really start creating some distance and some range, finding that button, utilize that jab, utilize those push kicks.
Step through knee there from Regian Eersel. Referee Atsushi Onari doing a fine job of officiating here. Riddell tried for the overhand right. Eersel on the front foot, double forearm guard against the round kick. Eersel gets airborne with the knee. We're seeing the intensity upped here from Regian Eersel. Glances towards Doug Viney in his corner, does Brad Riddell. Let's not forget Riddell competed only about a month and 10 days ago in Melbourne, Australia. Scored a victory down there. Sorry, very quick turnaround. Oh, knee to the liver. Smack bang. And it folds Brad Riddell in half. The always painful knee to the liver. It was excellent in execution from Regian Eersel. And Riddell up by the count of 8. 3-2 there from Riddell, but he may be in trouble. Here come the knees again from the tall Dutchman. The power of the left knee to the liver. Brad Riddell goes to the body. Eersel's unlocked the knees here in the second round, and that's a 10-8 round for Regian Eersel.
That's the knee, that's the game changer. It didn't connect on the head, but it did go to the body. Look at the way Eersel was moving in, always finishing with the knee, but this time, boom, right there on the side, he goes after it again. Getting hit in the liver is like throwing the switch on your body. Your entire body just shuts down. It looked like that might have been a hook. I'd like to see that again. What exactly was the shot that dropped Riddell? But that was a beautifully timed shot that went right to the liver.
There's nothing like a liver shot. Bas Rutten made them famous. Bernard Hopkins in boxing. Ricky Hatton KO'd Jose Luis Castillo in 2007 with a liver shot. Ernesto Hoost stopped Mirko Krokop with a liver shot. It hits the right side of the body around the floating ribs there. 9th and 10th ribs impacts the vagus nerve, puts the whole body into shutdown mode. And that's what Regian Eersel did to Brad Riddell in the second. Here we go, third round. One super series is alive and are happening in Manila. And Brad Riddell opens up like a house on fire.
That's the pace Riddell's got to keep in this third round, because Eersel's coming on strong now.
Toe to toe, and this crowd in Manila are loving it. Two world champions. That uppercut almost took out the ring lights. A 10-8 second round for Regian Eersel. After most likely a 10-9 opening round for Brad Riddell.
It's all going to come down to this one.
Right hand down the center corridor from Riddell, but not moving as freely as he was earlier on. Now backs up Eersel, but he can't corner it. He can't cut off the ring movement of the towering Dutch. Eersel with the knees again. No grappling in knees under these kickboxing rules. You can step through with the knee and then pull back. Eersel outside thigh kick. Riddell tries to counter off it. Roundhouse kick from the Kiwi. Goes to the body, then up to the head. Got to watch that rising knee, the meet and greet from Regian Eersel. Accidental groin shot there from Eersel. Referee Atsushi Onari, just make sure Riddell's okay. Good forearm guard against the roundhouse kick from Riddell. Tries to get on the inside. Oh, knee to the solar plexus there. And a body shot from Brad Riddell. What a tremendously entertaining contest to launch one super series. Looks for the inside lead, but Riddell a little too clever and got out of dodge. Left hook from Riddell. There's the right hand. Eersel on the front foot now. The Surinamese Dutchman. A very proud heritage of Surinamese kickboxers, the likes of Ernesto Hoost, Tyrone Spong, Remy Bonjasky, Melvin Manoff, and of course now, Regian Eersel. Very proud tradition of New Zealand kickboxers, of course. Ray Surfo, Mark Hunt, and here Brad Riddell. Body again from Riddell. Overhand right from the Kiwi, goes to the bread basket. And Eersel just shakes his head and comes forward with straight line attacks and a flying knee.
Those knees are intense. They come so fast. It was so much hip thrust behind him. But Riddell is still in there. He's the one putting the pressure on Eersel, coming forward, throwing the hands, really putting in work, not allowing Eersel to get comfortable and settle into these shots.
Left hook, right hand combination, the old 3-2 there from Brad Riddell. Has Riddell got a final salvo here, or a knee perhaps, or Regian Eersel? Final seconds of the bout, and it's in the history books. One Super Series has officially launched, and it launched with an absolute rip snorter.
It might, that body shot might have been the difference maker in this match. Here's some of that action. Nice left upper, right uppercut rather, from Riddell. These guys putting it all on the line, going back and forth with full contact action. I like the way Riddell goes to the body, goes back up to the head, but those knees from Eersel are just punishing. You can hear them all the way over here, Michael.
Right now, let's go up to Dominic Lau to find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. From the blue corner, Regian Eersel.
Regian Eersel enters his name into the history books. He will always be remembered as the first ever winner in the One Super Series. The beautiful step through knees, particularly the one in the second round to the liver that dropped Brad Riddell. A tremendous performance from Riddell as well. And that was a thrilling way to launch One Super Series.